Hey y'all, happy What to Do Wednesday. Time on the 23rd of March 2022 is 5:03 p.m. I hope everyone's had a well and wonderful day. Don't mind me, I'm just testing out the whole like the filter thing that's going on. I'm enjoying all this right now. For JD, Diva, and a few other creators, if you ever need a background, just get bored and do some new stuff, they have filters for your eyes, your face, and all kinds of fun shit on here. It's called Snap Camera, and it's free! It's fun! I'm gonna be a unicorn next time, or a floating moon or some shit. I don't know. I'm having fun. I'm just testing out different products as I'm in the process of building and transferring out a couple of my old social media platforms and turning into something new, and gonna discontinue and cut some things off directly. So I'm having fun! So where do I start from here, you guys? Usually I don't vape, but see, for my nerves, even when I was going through situations where I had radiation and stuff like this, I prefer edibles, but it's a very different thing just to take the edge off, for, especially for PTSD, and keep you from having to sit there and strangle people and catch a case. Fuck the zombie apocalypse. We have the fucking fucktard apocalypse among us right now. There's a lot going on in our lives. We're going to pray about it, fix it, Jesus, and this bitch. I don't know. Yes, I will sit there and curse at the same time. I'll just be up keeping it 1,000. So I'm not going to say... I'm going to say a few things. My day has been very productive, all in good ways, and things come together, and just I'm enjoying this part of my journey. I'm highly amused, slightly annoyed by some shit, but I'm okay. I was supposed to get my hormone shot done this morning, but I overslept. I need to get my sleeping patterns back together, because some of you guys can tell I'm much more of a night owl. Since I've been on leave, I mean, I just sleep whenever the hell I want to. So I take those late afternoon, wonderful, yum yum, like siestas, nap time, then be up all night. I get my work. Hello. I'm not listening to his mouthpiece. This is what's going to happen right now. And I'm not regretting shit. I'm just getting further confirmation, and I'm staying focused, and people are not used to me saying the words no, and we are done, and I'm not fuck with you like that, and move on with your life. Go away. I'm not being funny because I want men, please understand. And this is so bad because I'm gonna put him on some games or some things. I know I've been summoned. I felt him before he even contacted me. I felt his spirit. That man is in my soul. I own your soul. But anyway, and it shows we're still connected, and he can't let go because he misses his supplies. He misses what we had. And again, we start this pattern again because now I see, for me, when I cut people off and say, don't contact me, I'm not hitting you up for shit. I'm not being funny about that. It bothers me because as we just had a conversation for seeing each other for the first time since October, even though he's made attempts to reach out to me since then, I'm on a different path. My life has gone on. Even for choosing to just stay with Bromeister, whatever situation we had, versus Dante, I'm done. I moved on. This dude is my number one in my spot, okay? Even as a homie. I'm not fucking with you anymore. I'm fucking him. You know what I mean? So my life goes on. Then I'll go away. Then miss what we have because, yeah, he could have had it all. But see, I believe in divine intervention. And design, because when you're going through moments, again, everything has a season. And some people have a tendency to stay in those seasons way longer than what they should have after the season should have ended. It turns to something else. And I'm stopping that shit. I have no interest in rekindling anything with this dude. However, his spirit calls for something. I keep sensing something. So I see what's happening right now. Just know there's nothing else. He misses how I laid the world at his feet, always cooking, always a chillax chick, always packing with hella snacks. Oh, he was fed well.
Mm-hmm.
what I want you to stop doing is that guilt trip and try to make people feel bad for saying the word no thing. That has gotten old with me. You don't have to back up to stay in your lane. I am not the same person you remember. What I'm going to do right now, so much to say, I am going to go ahead and I got some air fryer chicken. Go ahead and do me some special like Southern style. And I'm going to make some vegetables and saute those up. And I am going to make some tea. I'm going to go over projects and finish what I've started. I'm happy with my pattern right now and I'm standing my ground. I'm not entertaining any foolishness. And I'm being tested. I'm not going to talk about OPD right now. We're going to pray about it. But it's interesting how I don't even have to say or do anything. I just watch you sit there and hang yourself. And it's more that's going on. This is just the beginning. So I swear my dad's probably enjoying his birthday this month for the shit that's going on. Because something's woken up and sparked. It's some bigger pictures on several different levels and some stuff that's going on behind them closed doors. And I'm just going to sit there and pray about it. But, you know, whatever's done in dark shall come to light one way or another. Not going to be cool and a big advocate for law enforcement, but also understand, too, at the same point, how politics works, especially with government and dishonesties and some mess like high school drama. Not everybody, there's some great cops out there. I just pick up on the bullshit. I say, trust your gut. Sometimes your soul knows some things before you do. And everything after becomes consistent confirmation as you start connecting all the dots. And not just by me assuming shit is like me, actually having phone calls all of a sudden, some shit don't make sense and this pops up. I'm getting screenshots of what just happened right now. And she said one thing, but that's not what I'm looking at. So again, you lied. And I didn't know the connection between who and who. I know eyes and ears, I'm always being watched. I'm used to this. I find it comical, yet annoying. So, yeah, I woke back up and staying focused. And I don't feel any type of way about Dante. I'm going to say it like that. I'm listening to him, and he's doing his pattern of the gaslight love bombing. I'm trying to make you feel bad. Feel bad because I was the only one, and he's 51 years old, that almost gave him his son. He wanted the son so bad, just wanted to have a child. My tubes are tied. So even with that, I have that top of pregnancy. Neither one of those babies carry through. But you know what? It was meant to be that way. I dodged a bullet. Where is my, hold on a second, you guys. I'm back. So anyway, make a long story short, the guilt trip thing is I'm not even trying to make things work with him. I really have moved on. I really don't feel anything about me misses him. And he is trying his hardest. So again, the love bomb about how he remembers how happy we were together and always having fun and doing something. Yet he forgets it was at my expense and how much he put me through. Even for losing both those babies by. Well, he's thirsty. So what I'm going to do. You're not respecting my boundaries. You know that. I am not doing back and forth with you. But you already know what you're doing. I really want you to pay attention to your behaviors. Even in grabbing my ass after I let you know we are done. And I'm on a whole different journey. So how does that work? Have a good shift. I don't trust him for shit. Seriously. So I'm going to do him like I did to bro. But see, Dante's different. Because for those incidents and things, he can get put back into prison. I'm not trying to hurt people. I just want people to leave me alone. Stop contacting me if we're done. Even for today, he called on his lunch break. He's trying to rekindle and think like we're back into a relationship. Hell the fuck no, we're not. You don't see me reaching out to contact you. My life has gone on. How many times have I told you that? Even for spiritual callings, and I am a priestess and a practitioner, you're supposed to be an ordained minister, and you speak the word. But again, it's for your selfish gain, because as you said best, you're hungry and you're horny. So as he's trying to make people feel bad because, woe is me, you haven't eaten this long and you're full, you just need to eat something, you're so tired, but you need me. No, you need to have my services, dear. And those services are discontinued. Do you understand what I'm saying? People are not used to the words no. And I want to turn tables, like really going to make him think about this and put it in his head. I had the conversation. I'm done talking. How many different ways can a female say that she is not fucking with you, has no interest in having any connection with you moving forward? She has gone on with her life. She's even gotten to a couple other situations. She has either gone off, got married. She has turned to a dude. She is listening to whatever her calling is and not wanting to, like, I'm not even in that lifestyle anymore. No more as far as that part of my life, as far as me healing and for spiritual purposes, anything sexual, I'm done with men. Do you understand? Even though I'm becoming one, I'll still be the homeboy, but stay in your lane. So he is trying to find every excuse he can to make me feel sorry for him, to get back into my personal space or me into his. That's not going to happen. I don't feel comfortable. And I hate when people don't own their bullshit or refuse to think I'm stupid. So, for instance, what just happened right now, how many, I've actually talked to him again earlier. I said, I want you to really focus on me and you are no longer. I'll be cool and help you along the way, but we're not friends. Don't just make sure you get it out of your head, because whatever I talk to, even from one practitioner to another, you understand it, but you're not applying it. You're trying to sit there and hinder and be a distraction to my personal journey. You're not respecting my boundaries. So where you're expecting the whole treatment before, because I always cook for you, cater to you, just ride or die. You had a personal assistant, all that stuff, even for right now with some shit. You're expecting to have yourself catered to and have that attention and that validation and the whole other perks that go with it. And I'm just a chill ass chick. That's about to be a dude. That's another thing, too. We're not having no damn kids talking about, you are going to be my baby mama. You always going to be mine. That was a conversation today. Twice. No. You got me fucked up. And I'm doing this on purpose. The reason why I'm taking testosterone shots every week. I'm transforming. And not just that. My tubes are tied. I already had my little 22-year-old. I did my prison time in parenthood, okay? My patience level is not set up or taken care of. If kids, I like looking at them. I'll go ahead and spoil them and give them back, okay? But if you're 51 and I'm already like 44, by the time that kid turns 20, all that shit, you're going to be missing on all these things you should have done. And I don't have the patience. That means I'm going to be locked into you. And so for ladies, for men too, make sure it's understood, because most men sit there and say that it's the female trying to lock some dude down and get pregnant just to keep him. I heard the hell out of that. I'm fixing, trying to hella fix myself. Testosterone shut all that down, okay? My equipment is going to be discontinued. And I'm not going to be penetrated by you. It's not going to happen, sir. Because this thing right now, he's saying you're always going to be mine, and no matter what. His thing is, if I had his baby, keeps saying that, you know, you're going to have my son. I'm going to come over there and make you have my son. I wish a motherfucker did. I say, he's like, I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to give you a domestic violence order. That's filed, that's sitting on my desk. I'm trying to be nice. He thinks I'm playing. It's in the court system. I just didn't file it in Klutz because I have to have him serve. I'm trying to be cool. What part do people say mean when I say do not contact me? Do people not understand? Just help me understand, please. And it's so funny because turntables, let it be you going through that situation. It's somebody you have cut off, somebody who did you wrong, hurt you, broke your heart. How would you feel if they're doing the same thing to you that you're doing to me? That's exactly what's happening. I'm trying to move on with my life. I have moved on. And you keep coming back and holding on to someone who does not want to hold back on to you. I really want people to ask themselves, if she says she's done with you or he's done with you, why are you trying to keep either guilt tripping to get what you want, or the gaslighting thing, or the love bombing thing, and still trying to make people feel guilty and trying to remember some bits of what made you and that person happy? And that person does not want you anymore. They made it directly clear. I'm not in love with you. I've never been in love with you. I tried to love on you. I have love for you, but that's it. And I'm done investing in the people who don't invest in themselves and not investing back. I meant what I said. So where he's used to having everybody else save him, and always, he's never been alone. I'm gonna ask, this is his test right now too, because I know when I was going through shit for good and bad, I was by myself. Those nights while he went home to his whole ass wife and I still had to search for a fucking motel to stay, and he never helped with any of that shit. You can't be mad at Mr. Will or one of my coworkers who was kind of like a sugar daddy. Because when I was homeless from late January 2018, because my benefits and I kicked in, my government benefits were done. Mr. Will, even if I did business projects with him, and yes, he was crushing on me, but that man paid for about 95% of me finding a place to lay my head and making sure I was okay at night. So from January all the way to April 10th, my dude, that's way over $10,000. And then some. What'd you do? There's other people who helped me along the way, but where were you? For that, I mean, everything had to make you feel like you had to be owed something. So, but I always helped and make sure you had food in your tummy. And like, even when I was sitting and going through changes, you know what I mean? I fed you before I fed myself. That says a lot. And on your hustle, they never asked you for a dime. I shouldn't have to. But as I had to go through the trenches and lose everything in order to regain everything again and get better, it's your turn now. Because otherwise, you're not going to appreciate shit. It's time for you to go ahead and be alone and study yourself and get your shit together. Because you're not qualified for me. I'm going to leave it like that. I'm not trying to put him down like that. He's just not my type of dude. I've gone on too much hurt. Enough damage has been done. We had some great times. That's fine. The season is over. Stop holding on to people who do not want to be held on to by you. So, as he's trying to make me feel bad or try to, it didn't work. I'm not falling for that shit anymore. I'm not jumping to his aid. Wherever he is, he can sit there and go grab him something to eat or go cook for himself. I'm done with Captain Save a Melho, okay? I'm done with Captain Dudes. I'm done being Captain Save a fuck boy. I don't know what to say. But aside from that, I'm going to sit there and make something to eat. I am going to take a break before my last conference call. And I'll probably head out tonight on a couple projects. I just think it's interesting with timing right now. And I'm proud of myself because I'm actually focusing. So any type of distractions, things that are healthy for my spirit, I'm applying what I've learned from the previous lessons. And I'm not even mad about shit, but I am going to talk to him. When he calls me, he makes one more. And so even for this, he knows that he can't get in one way. So I don't feel, I know what I said, I do not feel comfortable being with him in private as far as him coming over here and me coming to where he is. And I know he's expecting. And even when we hang, like he wants to go play pool and just have fun. You're trying to try everything you can do now to sit there and spend time. But even when we go hang out, you're gonna try to be putting your fucking hand up my skirt again or grab my booty, be humping on me while I'm sitting there bent over the damn pool table. No! He's talking about I'm gonna catch this loving. Y'all told him, he said, you're gonna catch a Glock. Or y'all catch my 86 sour, or you'll be catching a fucking taser gun. You'll be catching some pepper spray. No means no. And that shit gets weird because as I just finished this shit from him, then to bro, then to him again, I think bro got the point though. I don't want to have to hurt people. The main thing is just to have people stop. When you've had enough and things have just, you've outgrown and just evolved past each other, that's okay. But stop pushing yourself up on people. Stop coming back and reflecting on the good times and things we could have had. You know what I mean? We're done. The season's ended. So move on and be a better you for the next person. Not everybody likes that. And even for daddy's neighbor at one point, he was pushing a little bit, but not too much. But I cut that off too. That's why I say I'm very upfront. So the quicker I catch this stuff, and it's a pattern, the quicker I shut it down. You feel me? Again, no means no. If a female has to repeat herself and saying she's not interested, or a dude, let them go. I think that's fair game. So aside from that, I have a couple emails, a couple meetings, and I'll probably go ahead and head out. And I'm going to make dinner in the meantime and just chill. My day has been well. I'm not second guessing anything. I'm just preparing for the conversation we have to have, because it's one thing for me to say it, and I've been warning and saying it directly, but for me to actually follow through with the actions, and that order's been sitting here and there's not going to be enough time to serve it. If I have to refile, and which I'm going to do tomorrow, and do a request to extend or for continuance, I'm going to have to. Now, if he can be cool and actually respect lanes and boundaries and be a friend and stay in his lane, I'm not your girlfriend, I'm not your wifey, I'm not your fucking fiance, I'm not even baby mama, motherfucker, I'm actually gonna be baby daddy. How does that work? He was laughing about that shit too. I'm telling you, even for gender appropriation, don't stop the show. How does that work? I don't know. I'm making my intentions clear directly to him. So if he can't respect my boundaries, I'm going to make sure he's served. Stay away, do not ever contact me again. If I can let go and move on, you have to find a way to sit there and make your own closure. And I'm cool. I'm not even mad. I'm just done. Even if he needs help with one of his legal projects, I'll do that at no expense for me, even though I could charge his ass. We have to work on his finances, though. He just needs to get back and actually rebuild his own freedom. Welcome to the School of Hard Knocks, my dear. He'll be okay. Just he has to learn to stand on his own. It all starts with you. So anyway, you guys, I don't have too much else to talk about for the OPD thing. I know some things are connected. I had some conversations last night, and I'm not just flying off the handle. It's just some things are tied to other situations that go beyond that current project. You know what I mean? And I'm just very funny about foolishness and gossip and just, I'll say, office politics. And I know some shit. I'm just sitting here looking, and I don't trust it. And people underestimate me and wasn't expecting me to pull that wild card. So whatever you say, let me discount what you said. So please correct yourself and let me refresh your memory. And you may want to resolve that now. So anyway, not looking for a battle. I'm just making sure I stand my ground. And I have an allergic reaction of bullshit, foolishness, and fuckery. And I don't trust some things. And I know better. So anyway, you guys have a great day. I am doing all right. I still have to get another shot done. Oh, and I figured out, so for my, the Sex Change Chronicles, okay? So the gender appropriation that's going on, because they shot me in my stomach, okay? And the specialist treating me, who is also transgender male, tell, so she's like a born a female, but she's in a dude's body. She didn't do the hormones, but you still will see the features and stuff. That's cool. And I like her nursing assistant too. She's cool as hell too. And we just know each other by first name. But what they did not tell me to do, because I forgot how thick, I didn't know, because I've seen other people take hormones, but I forgot about it's thick as far as the oil that goes into your body. And so even if they have to go through a fat spot, it gets injected to your muscle. I did not know that you have to rub your tummy for a certain period after you get shot in that area, I guess because the muscle mass they shoot into the testosterone in there, it can clump and form up because it's a thick oil. So I guess you have to rub it with some alcohol or something. I didn't know that until today. So that explains the golf ball that's in my tum-tum. In the meantime, I missed my injection. So I'm going to sit there and go either way sometime before the end of the week. But I have them inject me one more time because I'm still not ready. Oh no, I have hella tattoos. That'd be a tattoo needle to death. But I don't like the medical needles. They hurt. If I'm used to it. Other than that, yeah, make sure whoever's doing transgender or gender appropriation, make sure in your tummy, after you get shot or whether they shoot you, you have to rub that area for a while and put alcohol on it. For what reason, I don't know, but I'll find out, because I know that my ex, who's also a doctor, my primary care physician, and I have a meeting with him too. I know he can't wait to see me. He's like, he's not happy. That's what a homie. I still love him though. You know what I mean? But I know he's going to spec my body. So whoever can give me that next shot, I'm not ready for these needles again. That's a lot happening in my life, y'all, but it's worth it. You can feel the difference. Slowly but surely. Oh no, I'm starting to get a little buff. Oh no. I'm gonna climb a tree. I don't know if I'm going hunting. You might want to slap box in the Royal Park. What's up? Let's try some police defense tactics. I don't know. Let's do something. Anyway, let me stop. I know I'm goofy, but I'm having a good time otherwise, you guys. Everything's coming together. It's just a lot at one time. So anyway, whatever you guys are going through, because we're all in this thing called life together, find a reason to smile and be grateful, even with the crazy times that don't make sense. And I swear God has a sense of humor. If her baby daddy stops speaking shit to existence, I am not trying to procreate. I don't even want you anywhere near me like that. Stay 6 feet away. That's why you can't be in the same space. He was looking for me to cook for him tonight. His two words, regardless of what the fuck conversation we had on spiritual levels, I guess he just dismissed all my shit. You get it, but you don't get it. He doesn't accept it. It was like he's happy and he's he's horny and he's hungry. That's what he said. I was like, go find you a girl. You know what I'm saying? All these girls have been hitting on you. Go find you something. Go pick something up to eat. You know what I'm saying? Stop at the store. You better blow on the budget. He was looking for me to sit there and attend to him. And now he wants to sit there and play video games with me because he knows I'm a big kid too. And he can't. I don't feel comfortable him being over here. Whatever he says is not what's showing the subconscious, and I'm cool. Mm-mm. I meant what I said and not even tempted. I really want people to think, if you know that you hurt somebody and broke their heart, however you did it, and you acknowledge it, you know it, and you know that person would be better off without you, and they're letting you go, don't reach out to you for shit, they moved on. Why do you keep coming back to further hurt that person? You're still that same ass person. You can't go back to the person who brought you harm or destroyed your life or broke your heart and expect that person to heal you. That's why I say run. Let that person go. You go into your next chapter. You find your own happiness, but still be grateful for the lesson that you learned in this process. So that's why I'm not even tripping. He's like, I'm just a chill chick. Because I know what I'm dealing with now. Now that I know what I'm dealing with, and I'm not mad. I'm not even hurt. I'm done. And I lost respect for you. That's even worse. Talking about let's start over and do a do-over. No, I heard the fuck out of that. You've never been my friend. You're trying to make me into a wife. Baby mama, that's not going to happen. Nope, I'm good. And as far as the bedroom thing, I meant what I said to him too, not trying to hurt him, but being honest. I don't know about you. And I'm not trying to hate on him because he has a very nice physique. But Broski sat there and shut the whole system down. Oh no, bro's number one. I meant what I said. I'm not gonna go into detail about that. He was very effective at what he does. And plus I had a deeper connection with him. I actually had real genuine like love or care for my dude. Not like that though. You know what I mean? But Dante, nah. That's like going back from being upgraded from a fucking Oscar Mayer wiener going into a fucking Wagyu steak or some shit. You know what I mean? Or a ribeye. That's Broski. So then you're looking back at Oscar Mayer brand like bologna sandwiches and shit. I'm like, what the fuck is this supposed to do? No, we're good. No, but my spirit's been calling. I'm sticking strong to my word. And I don't care what the fuck Dante says. And I want him to realize this too, because he's punishing and hurting himself. But the more I reject him and the more I'm truthful about things, not with the intent to hurt, but being honest, I'm not in love with you. I don't want you. I don't miss you. My life has gone on. So the more that you keep trying to come around and make attempts to get back into my life, and you can see clearly I'm starting to get a little bit more and more agitated. How do you think if you had a daughter, if some dude was doing that to her and just could not go away, still pushing himself on her, you know, it's not cool. And again, have enough love and respect for me to let me go if I'm letting you go. I mean, you have to. Enjoy the lesson you learned. Just aim to be a better you for yourself and the next person you choose to be with. But just know it's not mean. I meant the fuck I said. I'm not tempted about shit. So anyway, that's pretty much my day. If he doesn't get off of work till 11 o'clock, and I know he's going to hit me up probably close to midnight because he's a supervisor. I'm not available. My phone's getting turned off. I'm turning it off on purpose. Shit. What's going on? Do not disturb mode. So you can miss me with everything. I am unavailable. Mm-mm. You're going to have to learn. This is not new for, this is new for him. He's not used to me saying the words no. And it makes me mad because you're trying, you want me to sacrifice my spiritual calling and things I mentioned to you that I'm healing from in order for you to sit there and cater to for your selfish needs. Shows me how much you sit there and like really support your friends. Where's what I can do for you? That part. So aside from that, my day has been well. I am blessed. Things are happening. Good stuff and like a murder mystery type of thing and all kinds of stuff. It's like playing Clue. Like, I swear between people keep asking, how come you said I should have been an attorney? Yeah, I know. But dude, peace of mind and the shit you be going through. I might be good at what I do in a lot of levels with a lot of things. Does not mean I enjoy them. You know what I mean? That's two different things. That is no, I can't wait to start to my new position at my job and just get this stuff started. I'm proud of myself because I stood my ground. I don't feel bad. Stop letting people, stop for those narcissists. Y'all stop trying to make people feel bad for saying the word no or feel guilty or feel like they have to obligate themselves to you just for your selfish gain. That's not fair. Don't forget, my life exists outside of you. You're no longer in my system for this part. So you gotta go. You know what I mean? So anyway, that's it. And that's my ramble for the day, my rant for the day. I want everyone to have a blessed day. Find a reason to smile. Put on some good music. I'm about to do some air fryer wings. You know what I mean? And do it with some buttermilk in there too. It's going down. And there's some vegetables. And just chill for a minute before my next call. Anyway, you guys have a good one. God bless.